Sorry, I didn't want to ruin the surprise for you guys.
Okay. Pow!
What's up, guys? Maurice McDonald. Love you. I just wanted to ask you guys a quick question. A couple, actually, quick questions. How many of y'all listen to music? Awesome. I love that. How many of y'all can tell me what a talent manager, artist manager, anything like that is? Okay, all right. Well, I'm gonna ask y'all just a couple questions. I mean, who is this? Obviously, you might not
know. Kanye.
Hey, you guys know who that is?
I thought that was Jay-Z.
Awesome. Do y'all know who this is?
What is
that? No, all my friends are dead. Push me to the edge. Okay.
Oh.
Yeah. All right, okay. What about this?
I know y'all have
Boo-boo.
No.
Boo-boo, all right. Okay. What about this? Can I know who this is?
No.
No? Nobody?
No.
You're calling?
No. Anybody? Yeah, I know that guy.
You do?
No.
Okay, awesome. That's even better. What about Scooter Braun?
Yeah.
Oh, he's hot.
There it is. He's actually Justin Bieber's manager.
Oh.
So today I wanted to talk to you guys and just be able to inform you guys actually about artist management. First point, what it is. Second point, what they actually do. Third point, how to keep them, how to lose them, all right? So first, in talking to my live reporting type of deal, like I have an actual artist management friend, and he told me, Jeffrey Moreno, he told me just a little bit of insight the past month that we've been working on this, how artist managers come about and all that, and we talked about coming into the actual game or the music industry. You need somebody that is able to do things that you're not doing. You're doing music, you're doing touring, you're doing collaborations with other artists. You're not trying to worry about paperwork. You're not trying to worry about tour date sales. You're not trying to worry about tour merch and all that stuff. Your job is just to make music. So that's when artist management and managers come in. So in my first point, I'd like to just inform you actually what an artist manager is. So an artist management is a person that, or an individual that advises and counsels your talent and counsels talent based off whatever genre they're in. So my second good point is going to be what artist managers actually do. And so artist managers are more in charge of like hand-to-hand stuff with artists. So they would be in charge of getting like an artist to one plateau level to another. So say you just start off as a guy you only see on YouTube, you want to be on the radio, you want to be on Sirius, you want to be on maybe Shade 45 for any of you guys that have satellite radio. I don't know if you guys might listen to them. So as an artist manager, that is your job to push and maybe just upstart your artist. So we start with the first, I guess, term for a manager, and that is actually just being a day-to-day manager. So day-to-day managers are in charge of what your artist is gonna do that day. Are you gonna go to studio time? Are you gonna go to eat with high-level executives? Are you going to get on a plane and jump to LA to do shows? What are you gonna do? The second point in my sub-points is a tour manager. So when you go on tour, you might have your day-to-day manager just chilling and relaxing, or maybe he can do it all, you know? So while on tour, you're in charge of tour merch. You're in charge of routing. We're gonna go from this city, we're gonna go to LA, we're gonna go to San Diego, then we're gonna go to maybe an international venue. It might be Hong Kong, it might be you were in the Philippines just this summer. It might be something to that nature. So when you're on the road, your tour manager is pretty much like a big time babysitter. So they're also in charge of financial status. So when you go to a venue and you just perform in front of 1,000, 2,000 people, your road manager is in charge of making sure that you and the rest of the people with you get paid, making sure your band members get paid, making sure your I guess other part of your artists get paid. So lastly is keeping an artist happy. When talking with Mr. Paul Allen, who wrote actually the book Artist Management from Business Revenues, he said that the number one thing in keeping your artists happy is keeping them well paid. So for anything, and I think anyone that's in here, being an artist or being a teacher or being a student or being just an employee of anything, you definitely want to get paid. So in handling all that, you can't just go and do things and not get paid. You know, like, you have to be on top of stuff like that. And as an artist, that's not your job to worry about secondhand stuff. So you want to get paid on time. And the second point of keeping an artist happy is making sure that you can just allow them to be themselves. When working with the artist and being a manager, you don't want to overimpose your thoughts on an artist. You want to allow them to be free. You want to allow them to be their own person, because making music is a complex, in art of any nature like that, you create a sidewalk art. So if I told you exactly what to do, instead of you just filling it out, it wouldn't be your creation anymore, you know? So being an artist is all about freedom and allowing yourself to be one with whatever you do. And wrapping that all up, I told you guys what being an artist was, or being an artist manager was. I told you what it took to be an artist manager. I told you what type of different managers there are. And I hope just in this 6 to 7 minutes, I was able just to at least just give you a rough breakdown of what it might be. And hopefully you guys can take it from there.